We'll see. It's Truls Morgaard to start off with the serves in this best of five. Lovell. And a chop block to start it off, but it sits up a little bit, and Wang Chuqin right there to clean up.
Probably a sign of things to come with Truls, the Swedish box of tricks.
Yeah, I hope you guys like side spin. Good pressure on the stroke. I mean, we saw him against Hugo Calderano. Hugo, one of the best in the world, but you can see how jarring it is to play someone who just has no fear and is constantly changing his tactics.
Yeah, that's the advantage that he has over Wang Chuqin. Wang Chuqin, you know, no one can really match him for power. Not many anyway. But it's the unpredictability factor of Truls that gives him a chance.
Good question there from Wang Chuqin. He said inside, was I serving inside the table? He serves closer to the back line of the table than anybody in the game that I've seen. Apparently just crossed it. For me, Wang Chuqin is just getting better and better. I mean, he had his defeat at the hands of Tomokazu Harimoto in Chengdu recently.
He hasn't disappointed me in any of the big tournaments. Not in this event either, and not in last week. Being the winner, made his debut at the World Championships in 2019, only in doubles, and he won it with Ma Long. 2021, he only fell short to the winner, Fan Shendong.
You can see how much power he has inside the table. Two for two against the chop blocks. Truls Morgaard's made both of his shots, but they haven't been effective yet. He's going to have to look and find ways to be close. Surprise. I mean, some of the same ingredients for all the matches, but really what's necessary at this level. And a good exchange here. Gets a few back. But when the big forehand comes out, goes for the counter.
I feel like Truls will want to try and use his feeling a little bit earlier. Not in an emergency situation, but to try and get Wang Chuqin passive, and then Truls will try and be aggressive, because we know he's good at stepping the corner and playing the big forehand as well, Morgaard.
An escape for me. I agree with you. Early in the rally is going to be important. If he can use all that feeling with precision to keep Wang Chuqin off the attack and then set up a next ball for Truls that's attackable, that's what it's all about. And a good tight serve here, that shovel serve. Oh, starts to turn, thought he had him cuffed. Thought there were no options for Wang Chuqin, and as Wang Chuqin sees his opponent turn, just able to play right down the line. So quick, that change of heart.
I'm not quite sure whether that serve was around the nettable, but I think that was as good as a forehand you can play off that serve.
8-3.
He's got an air of arrogance, but in a good way, Wang Chuqin. Bit of a bad boy on the table, and I like to see that.
I think that could be said for both of these players. There is a confidence from both of them. I think it's always been that way. You know, Wang Chuqin, you look back before he played Dima, looking at the last time they played, what, maybe 2015 Chinese Super League?
Yeah.
I mean, he was a fighter. Wang Chuqin was roaring up a storm. We've seen Truls Morgaard, too. Beautiful shot here. To the wide, wide corner.
A unique training method. The Swedes. Perfect shot.
Yeah, talk to me about that.
Just the multi-ball and how they implement feeling into their training.
Well, this is placement, the backhand. It's so interesting. Sometimes you get the spin shot, sometimes a punch, and this felt like a swatting backhand. Something in between, right?
Yeah. He's got a unique hammer grip, Truls Morgaard, and he's developed the backhand topspin. He used to only kind of punch and block as a junior.
And the counter down the line brings it right back to where it came from with interest under pressure. Look at the score line here. He was down, what, 1-6? That touch, perfect placement to the corner.
Absolutely audacious from Morgaard. I bet if that was in training, Wang Chuqin would smile at that.
Late. 8-7.
That's right, you'd probably see a little smile, a little applause. Much better chop block this time around. Low to the net, shallow, barely comes off the table. The first time Wang Chuqin hasn't had an answer.
He's so good when he's behind Morrigard. Think about the matches. Saves match points against Francisco at the World's. Lim Jong-hoon 3-0 down. Chuang Chuan at the European Summer Series 2-0 down.
But this one a bit too much control here. Wang Chuqin able to make the most of the opportunity.
He ain't the kind of guy to blow a lead, Wang Chuqin, it seems.
I think we'll all remember that comeback from down 4-9 against Shunsuke Togami. That is a tough one, a big point here. Wang Chuqin with the save. That chop block was very handcuffing, left him in an uncomfortable position. And I think Truls Morgaard's very capable of that counter, so it's gonna be a tough pill for Morgaard to swallow. But it's two game points now for Wang Chuqin of China. And trying to scoop it up from under the table, Truls Morgaard. A little bit flatter shot off the backhand, but nice touch on the receive. Truls able to keep it really short.
Players that have been able to beat the aggressive Chinese are ones that can slow things down. Michael Mays, Timo Boll. Not Dmitry Ovcharov so much, I must say. Plays with feeling, give the Chinese things that they're not so used to.
Just to clarify on what you were saying, Dmitry Ovcharov can beat the Chinese, but not slowing down.
No.
Oh, speaking of which, a little spin comes in and a little speed comes back. Completely converted here by Wang Chuqin. With the racket that high, too. That's impressive to me. You think of racket speed coming from a little bit of backswing, but he had almost none. That's scary.
It is scary. He can produce a shot of that power with very little backswing and time. Wow.
I think Truls thought it was off the table for a minute. He stood up right there.
These are both very, very special players we are witnessing here. This is definitely the new generation of table tennis.
The slap across the body. Truls Morgaard, one of few with that slap shot. It's an unusual shot to take. Gutsy, risky. Look at the way he finishes that. Find that in any technique textbook.
You can't imagine any coaches teaching that, but Morgaard can do it with such a consistent basis. How could you not like that?
I think that's one thing that makes him so great to watch is that he has the confidence to do things that others would advise against. Not just not advise, but straight up advise against.
There's a rebelliousness to Truls Morrigard that's lovely.
Yes, yes, yes.
Lovely on the eye.
But the touch game here, Wang Chuqin sets himself up with a 4-point lead. Remember, the winner here plays Ma Long, and Wang Chuqin is 4-2. He is the kryptonite to the captain, the dragon, the dictator. And this time a bit more underspin on it. That heavy chop block pays off.
Butch will be backspin. I can see Chin Chijian stirring a little bit. The timeout is on the cards, perhaps, if he loses his point.
Funny, we saw a shot of Jorgen Persson going for some water in that moment. Beautiful down the line again. No backswing, very little anyway. I mean, the power that he generates. Watch one more time. That just guiding that forward motion.
Yeah, forward's the word. All the energy is forward with Wang Chuqin. Seatbelt shot. Come on. Come on.
Some extra side spin here from Wang Chuqin. Truls Morgaard would love an opportunity like this to come back around the net. Heavy spin there to cover the middle. Excellent dodge to get the forehand into play. And just too shallow on the table. Wang Chuqin able to just send that ball off to the barriers. A tennis-like shot. Heavy side spin. Watch this, doesn't even turn the racket around. Heavy spin, knows exactly what to do. Normally you'd see someone turn a racket around on the Chinese team against that high lob. Oh, we feel you, Trolls. Oh, meme time.
10-3.
Wow, so the first game, well, it was fairly close, wasn't as close as the last time they played, the first three. But this is a real runaway here, 7 game points. And quickly dismissive. Wang Chuqin right now with more answers than questions. They say that Malta is the only player to play more crazy shots than Truls Morgaard, his brother's training partner.
Love one.
Looking for that cross-court shot. Truls Morgaard here in game three. It is a must win, but it will be quite an impressive turnaround after the last game. The side spin didn't seem to bother him. I mean, yeah. We saw Truls Morgaard do that against Hugo Calderano at game point to really make that ball. They showed a replay of it, and it hooked so much, the amount of side spin he gets.
It'll be interesting to see how the Chinese players prepare for Morgaard. Kind of wish I'd been able to go into the hall before this to see if Wang Chuqin's partner was giving him some uncomfortable, spinny, some feeling balls.
Yeah, I was going to say, you hire Alexis Lebrun, maybe. Yeah. Other than that, it's sort of tough. Can you imagine just being like, hey, Liu Dingshuo, go try anything creative you can think of.
I want you to play with Wang Chuqin. This is Qin Qijian speaking to Liu Dingshuo. I want you to just do chop blocks for an hour against him. Nothing but a chop block.
1-5.
So quite a start here. Truls Morgaard, after being beaten 11-3, takes 5 of the first 6 points in game number 3.
It's almost like he likes to write the story of each match in an interesting way, Morgaard.
The drama, he lives for the drama.
2-5.
It's a beautiful shot here from Wang Chuqin. A little acknowledgement of fortune there. Could have been the back edge, whatever it was quick, not easy for the naked eye to see. Surprise on the placement here, pressure, and it threw the legs, send back to the ball kids. Just missing the edge. It's tough if you can get a racket on it. The way he started this point, though, that's right, Fraser just showed me in the booth that heavy side spin shot that I think we were both sort of marveling at.
4-6.
Trying a dummy backhand there, and I don't mean stupid. I mean a backhand that looks like there's going to be a lot of top spin on, but you kind of just shove it up a little bit, not a lot of top spin.
A fake out, if you will, something to imply there's more on it than there is.
Momentum.
Where's the timeout? Here it is.
Timeout.
See how this first one plays out. Beautiful forehand slap. The flat hit to follow. That shovel serve with topspin. What do you think in the conversation was with Truls?
Be positive. Try and remove the attack. And then look what Wang Chuqin does. A serve which its sole purpose is to set it up. And he did it.
Finally, a shot out of reach. Wang Chuqin comes scarily close to getting a racket on that last one as well.
Unreal timing from Morgaard there on the forehand. Look at this last one. Goes right back to the table as well. That's another reason why people think he's like Voldner. He rushes the serve.
Some momentum here. When you're playing well, why not keep it going? Not give your opponent a chance to really start to get comfortable or confident. Keep the train rolling through. That was missed by a lot, but a 1-point game here. Second serve, if Wang Chuqin can convert. He's come down, come back from quite a ways down. Chop block finds the net, and it is tied up. What do we see? 1-5 2-6. Tough to recall, but strong lead there for Morgard.
And it was 8-all in the first game. I'm getting flashbacks here, Trolls.
That shot. To even reach it is one thing. Wang Chuqi not only gets there, but smokes it past him.
That is just mad. Mad. How hard is it to beat Wang Chuqi in an individual game? What do you have to do?
Hit it back to him. Two match points now for Wang Chuqi. One save, though. Morgard in the touch play. Nervy, nervy play. Second match point for Wang Chuqi. Fast, long serve, and he turns. Morgard patiently waits.
From the young Swede.
Just missing the corner long. The exchange in this one was one of the best in some time. Again, fast, aggressive, and Wang Chuqi leaving very little unconverted. Third match point. How did he do that?
No,
that was
speechless.
Like a dance step.
No.
That was crazy. Pinch. No. Is this reality? Truls Morgard. Check out the replay on this one. Side swiping chop block, underspin, banana split with his feet crossed.
What do you call that shot?
Crazy. Absolutely crazy.
We need to work that one back at him afterwards.
I'm sure it'll be on the WTT social media. Can't wait to rewatch that about 100 times. Game point now for Truls Morgard. Takes his chances, goes for the shot, a little bit of height on it, and takes the risk.
Did Wang Chuqi see Truls move for the backhand flip from the forehand side there, which made him put a bit of backspin on. Not 100% sure.
It takes two in this, two outstanding shots, and he wipes the table with anger. Truls Morgard, corner to corner in this rally, and it's another game point. A chance to extend this match to a fourth game. Ooh. Almost deja vu, that chop blocked the rotation, and Wang Chuqi takes his chances following the serve.
He doesn't need to do something too different every single time, Morgard, when he's in a position to either come back or to win.
Came quite close, 14, to be fair. 13. But here a big forehand opening from Wang Chuqi. And the timeout now. Interesting. Let's see. Out of his timeout. Match point once again. And there it is, Wang Chuqi. 3-0. And Truls Morgard respects his opponent.